we feature the fifth round of the FA Cup. First of all, the all-Northern First Division tie at Roker Park between Sunderland and Leeds United. Here at Sunderland, 57,500 fans are packed into the stadium to see what promises to be one of the highlights of the fifth round, played in something approaching a howling gale. About 15,000 people have made the 100-mile journey across Yorkshire from Leeds to see their much-fancied team, which is quoted to win the cup at 30-2 against. Now, if we move some way down the East Coast, our second match features the cup giant killers Norwich City and last year's FA Cup finalists First Division Sheffield Wednesday. The home club fans at the Carrow Road ground are hoping for a great performance by Second Division Norwich City, who put out the much-fancied Manchester United in the last round. But now let's settle down with our cameras back here at Roker Park for today's big match between Sunderland and Leeds United. And Sunderland, putting great form, just at the moment, 10 games without defeat. That's their team. And two fellas to watch. Number four, Colin Todd. There he is, an 18-year-old, comes from Chesterley Street, and one of the great stars of the future, everybody up here says. And, of course, number six, gentleman Jim Baxter, a world-class player, a man who has, in fact, played for the rest of the world against England. Leeds United have been plagued with injuries, but they've managed to get out of side, and number seven, Madeley, will be the man watching Jim Baxter. And the big news, as far as the Leeds fans are concerned, is that number four, Billy Bremner, is fit. There he is, an unmistakable figure, a man who means so much to Leeds United. And Jackie Charlton, number five, back in what you might call his home territory of the Northeast. Mr. Tinkler of Boston, the referee, Leeds United to kick off. And we apologize for the shadow caused by the bright sun. We've got a bright sun and a howling gale of a wind. And for those who like to keep a record of the colors, Leeds in blue shirts and yellow shorts, or gold shorts, and Sunderland all in red. Goal kick to Sunderland. Jim Montgomery played so well for the England under-23s a couple of weeks back at Newcastle. Harvey, the ground, another firm, bouncing rather awkwardly. And it looks as if the winner of this tie could well be this howling game, whirling apparently in all directions. The flags are being wrapped around their flagpoles, so nobody can gauge which way the wind is blowing. Gareth Sprague, full international for Wales, great young goalkeeper. And that shows you how strong the wind is. 10. Wind is blowing more into the faces of Leeds players than anyone else. Hunter, they're going to spot a trouble, and there's Lorimer back to help them in defence. And Bell, he will be quite happy to come back and defend solidly. Irwin. And the got to bother with this lively ball. Kerr. Lovely move by Leeds. Kerr, number 10. Quarter of an hour gone. Still no score. Still so far, the win, very much the winner. Chance now for Sunderland. Oh, he's hit the post. O'Hare. Number 8, John O'Hare. There he is. Almost the first goal. That shows you how strong the wind still is. And mainly laying into the faces of the Leeds defenders. Martin. And then up Sunderland. The outswinger then this time. Pinnell. Wonder whether Sprague had that covered or whether Hunter really had to concede that corner. It's another corner for Sunderland, and it's Baxter to take it. Mulhall, now to Baxter.